In this diagram, we have two arcs centered at point P. Arc AB, and you could imagine this arc could be part of a circle like this that is centered at point AB. And then you have this arc CD that would be part of a larger circle just like that, centered at point P. And we don't know the actual angle measure of angle P right over here. But without even knowing that, just knowing the lengths of these segments here, I want to think about whether we can figure out the ratio of the length of arc AB, not angle AB, the length of arc AB to the length of arc, do that in green, the length of arc CD. And I encourage you to pause this video now and think about this on your own. Well, they didn't give us the radian measure here, or any type of angle measure here, but let's just imagine that it is x radians. X radians. We've already seen that one way to think about an angle measure in terms of radians is that this is a count of the number of the length of the arc that it intercepts in terms of radii. So if this has an angle measure of x radians, then that means that this arc length is going to be x times the radius. It's going to be x radii long. The radii is 5 units long, so this is going to be 5. Let me do that in that. Yeah, this is the right color. This is going to be 5x units long. Well, same argument for this arc length right over here. It has a radius of 9, 5 plus 4. And so this is going to be x radii long. Each radius is 9 units, so it's going to be 9x units long. So what's the ratio of these two lengths? Well, the smaller arc AB would have a length of 5x. Arc CD would have a length of 9x. So the ratio is 5 to 9. Now let's say someone says, oh, that was pretty good. You were able to figure out this ratio. Let's say we were to give you one of these lengths. Let's say that they were to tell you that the length of arc AB, let's say they tell you it is 25 over 8. Given that, what else could you figure out about it? Well, you could actually figure out everything else you would want to know. You could figure out the angle measure in terms of radians, and you could figure out the arc length of CD. And I encourage you to pause the video now and figure them out on your own. Well, let's work through each of them. This arc length, we already figured out that this arc AB's length is 5x. So we could just say that 5x is going to be equal to 25 over 8. Divide both sides by 5. X is equal to 5 over 8. And so the measure of this angle right over here is 5 over 8 radians. So what's going to be the measure of this arc length? So this is going to be 9 times x. That's just 45 over 8.